Hey everybody, Sexy Matt the Pharaoh Wizard here. So it's that special time of year again where everybody comes out with their obligatory top 10 lists, and I'm no different. So I'm bringing you Sexy Matt's top 10 movies of 2016. Of course, I haven't seen every movie. I think this year I saw about 25 movies, so this is the best of what I've seen so far, but let's get into it.
Number 10, Sausage Party.
A movie that people didn't even think was real and sounds more like a Saturday Night Live sketch rather than a real movie, Sausage Party came out of nowhere with some great satire and inappropriate humor, and is just a very funny, well-made movie. If you're into something with just ridiculous, over-the-top humor, tied in with obviously trying to be like a Pixar movie, you'll absolutely love this. Some of the funniest moments of the year came from this movie, and is just well done, and just the idea that a movie that looks so much like a kid's movie but being so inappropriate coming out today is such a great thing to see. I just really enjoyed this movie a lot.
They're eating children! Fucking children!
Number 9, Zootopia.
The other animated movie on my list, when I first saw the trailer for Zootopia, I really wasn't impressed. I thought it was just another, oh, animals are people type of movie, and didn't really look very good. How wrong I was, though. This movie is so well written and so well acted by everybody, not to mention the animation. But it's such a good movie with such a great message for children as well, where it's not just tolerance, but acceptance and, you know, not judging people right away, and just such a good idea and put out in such a fun way for everybody. And this is just such a great movie. I cannot praise it enough. Zootopia is great.
We are in a really big hurry.
I am on
it
break.
Number 8, Hardcore Henry.
Such a fun idea. I absolutely loved Hardcore Henry. Such a cool idea to have an over-the-top, dumb action movie done in the first person. And also, it's not afraid to be a dumb, over-the-top action movie. It knows exactly what it's trying to do and has fun with it. And I absolutely had fun with it as well. It has some great action, some great moments, and honestly is the best video game movie ever made, even though it's not even based on a video game. But it's totally done like a video game, and it just a great idea if you love that type of movie, and it's just really good fun and great action.
Number 7, The Hateful Eight.
I think this one just barely made the cut because I think it came out on New Year's Eve last year, something like that. But Hateful Eight is such a good movie, I wanted to make sure I included it on this list. It's got some great dialogue, as you expect from Quentin Tarantino, as well as some great action and some amazing acting done as well. It's kind of a murder mystery mixed with a western, mixed with, you know, just a bunch of genres, and it works so well. And it's just a really great movie to get through. If you haven't already seen it and you're a Tarantino fan, definitely add this to your list of movies to see. The Hateful Eight, it's hateful. Great.
Well, well, well. Looks like Minnie's haberdasher is about to get cozy for the next few days.
Yes, it does.
Number 6, Doctor Strange.
Possibly the last origin story we'll get from Marvel, Doctor Strange is Marvel's most beautifully made movie. It has such strong visual effects, along with a very well-made movie in general. The story of Doctor Strange coming from being an asshole surgeon to becoming the Sorcerer Supreme is such a great story to see, and something I never thought I'd ever see on the big screen. And it's just an amazing addition to the Marvel Cinematic Universe, and I can't wait to see more of Doctor Strange.
Wonder what I see in your future? Possibility.
Number 5, Rogue One.
The first anthology movie in the Star Wars franchise, Rogue One tells the tale of the rebels that stole the Death Star plans mentioned in the text scroll of A New Hope. And it's done so well, it's such a great idea to see the grunts on the ground. You know, no real lightsabers, it's just your battles on the ground, the grim, gritty war. You know, it's the first real war movie in Star Wars. You know, it's just a war movie with a sci-fi edge, and it's done so well. So many little nods to the other movies in the franchise as well. I know this one's pretty fresh in my mind still, but it's very fun, and I wholeheartedly enjoyed this movie.
There is a 97.6% chance of failure.
He means well.
Number 4, Star Trek Beyond.
The most Star Trek-iest Star Trek movie out of the new Star Treks, Star Trek Beyond is such a great movie, and I love the idea of breaking up the crew into little groups to see their interactions, and the overall storyline is fantastic. I love the addition of J-Law. She was a great character, a good villain, and just a solid entry into the Star Trek franchise. And another great one out of these new Star Treks we've been getting, and I can't wait till we get the next one.
Well, at least I won't die alone. Well, that's just typical.
Number 3, 10 Cloverfield Lane.
If you see a top 10 movie list and this isn't on it, then you can tell the person that made that list to go straight to hell. This is such a great movie. And the fact that we get a surprise movie in a day and age where we know everything about movies before they come out is so nuts to think about. But 10 Cloverfield Lane is so good, so creepy, with a truly haunting performance from John Goodman. For me, everything works about this movie. The mystery, just everything going on. It's so creepy, so weird. I absolutely love 10 Cloverfield Lane. It is great.
Number 2, Deadpool.
With Fox's track record with X-Men movie, it's a huge surprise they did not fuck up Deadpool. But they didn't. It was great. They really gave the character a lot of pathos, and there was just an affinity for Deadpool, and I think that's what worked best about this, is everyone involved really loved this character and wanted to do the best version they possibly could of him, and they definitely succeeded in this. It is a great movie. It's our best X-Men movie we've gotten. I think it's the best 20th Century Fox comic book movie ever made. A lot of things work about this. I wouldn't say everything. There's a few flubs here and there, but just the surprise that they did not fuck this up is so great, and I wholeheartedly enjoy this movie. Deadpool, bitches.
You are haunting.
You look like an avocado had sex with an older avocado.
Thank you.
Number 1, Captain America, Civil War.
Holy crap, what else can I say about Captain America Civil War that I haven't already? I rant and rave about this movie, and I absolutely love it. And even though it's a Captain America movie, this is definitely the Avengers sequel we really wanted. And this is what we wanted to see out of Marvel Phase 3. More team-ups with different heroes, and seeing interactions with them, and just expanding that world. And, you know, let's not forget the airport scene. That is the greatest comic book thing ever put to film. It's so amazing, and it's just such a great exclamation point on this already great movie, and I just love everything about Civil War. It works so well. I had so much fun with it. I don't know what else to say. It's great. I love it. Yeah. So that's my top 10 of 2016. What is your favorite movie of this year? What are you looking forward to next year? Let me know in the comments below. Hit that thumbs up. But thank you all for such a great year on my channel. It's so fun to do this for everybody. And it's just a good time, right? So until next time, I'm Sexy Matt the Pharaoh Wizard. Hold on to your hold slots.